Some time ago on the channel, I did a video on the Wilts and Berks Canal as it ran through Swindon, my hometown. Well, I'm just a few miles away now in the countryside, walking my dog, and this is the continuation of that same canal system. I'm filming this under the current lockdown restrictions we've got, so I haven't been able to travel too far. But this is the Wilts and Berks Canal near Shrivenham, my home village. I grew up in these parts as a boy and a young person. Anyway, the dog's keen to get on, as you can tell. This is all part of the Shrivenham circular walk. At this point, I can just see where they've managed to clear the canal, and you can see where they sort of stopped their workings, and you can see where the canal continues on. Anyway, we'll go along the towpath here, see where it leads us to. This here is a sarsen stone. Local sort of geology. These stones occur sporadically. Goodness knows how long they've been hanging around for. But I notice on this stone that a thresh, probably, I should imagine, a song thresh or a thresh, has been using it as an anvil to smash snail shells. Say hello to the people, the nice people on YouTube that want to watch you. Come on then. She's a good girl. She's getting used to my little funny ways when I go out on walks now. Obviously, stopping and starting with the camera and trying to get this shot and that shot. She didn't fully understand that yet. She wants to get on with her walk. But she is... really enjoying being out on the walks now, I'm glad to say. I'm trying to get her to new areas, get her different sniffs, get her acclimatised to the location so that she doesn't get worried when she goes to a new place. I lived in this village, the village of Shrivenham, from the ages of 11 till I got married at the age of 25. Mum and Dad are buried here. I can see the church in the distance. New housing developments. I guess it's progress. It's nice to come back every now and again, see the old place. Went out and about on these little walks with the cameras, making videos for the YouTube channel. There's a lot of start, stop, change direction with the dog on the lead, and I don't think she fully appreciates what's going on. Well, obviously she doesn't appreciate what's going on, but I'm told that having the dog on the lead and stop, start, change direction is a good thing. The dog's got to follow, it learns that you're the leader, and it's got to stay close at all times, so it's kind of benefiting her as well. There she is, look. Lovely old oak tree. I bet that's been here a couple hundred years or more. I wonder what stories it could tell. Possibly was here when the canal was being used. Part of the canal now. I'm approaching the Longcott Road area of where the canal passes. It looks as though it hasn't been restored at this point, but it's still holding water. Lots of willow, never herbage on the bank. I reckon that's pretty much original. Quite beautiful along here. I've got the canal to my left, to my right I've got open countryside. A lovely view across the downs from here. Well, from where this video started, I headed in an easterly direction. I got as far as I can get now. I've got to a gate which has got a chain on it. There's sheep in the field. I've got a sight hound with me. I'm not going to push me luck and go walking through sheep, but there's no point. So I'm going to turn around and head back and follow the track of the canal in a westerly direction for a little way. But interestingly, I come to a river here which is feeding into the canal. This river, judging from its course, it's only a small river. I guess most of the time it's probably just a little ditch, but it's draining from the chalk downland and heading towards Shrivenham. But I know just a bit further downstream it turns east and it goes to a place known as Beckett. There's a defence academy there, and there's a lovely old stately home, Beckett Hall, with some ornamental lakes. It feeds into those lakes and then it then goes on into the River Cole and then empties out into Letchlade on Thames. Retraced my steps now and heading in a westerly direction along the canal. Not been along this path for many years, so it's like new ground again for me. The dog's enjoying her walk. This is how it was left. It went into decay. The banks either side, many years ago, well, probably even now, had lots of rats. And when I was a young lad, I'm talking maybe going back now 40 years, I had permission to shoot on all the surrounding land down here, and I'd sit on the banks of the canal here, around about this area where I am now, and I shoot the rats on the opposite side with a little 410. And I had a dog with me at the time, and his name was Ben. And this dog, I didn't used to watch the far bank where the rats were. I used to watch the dog, and the dog would see the rats before I saw the rats. And so when the dog perked up and spotted something, then I knew I had to go across and survey the opposite bank, and sure enough there was always a rat, and I shot some pretty big rats down here. Anyway, that was years and years ago. Look at the canal now though. Station Road, and this is the old wharf bridge at Shrivenham. I should have known that. Anyway, I did know it, just informing you a bit late. that just about concludes this little video. Hope you found it interesting and enjoyable. Certainly been good to get out, get some fresh air and exercise, and also good for the dog as well, because with the filming, stopping here and starting and moving and changing direction, etc., I'm told with good authority that this is a good practice to do, especially with the dog on the lead, getting it to follow you and do whatever it is you're doing. When I'm down the park walking there on a normal walk, it feels a bit strange doing that, you know, doesn't seem right somehow. But when you've got a camera and you've got a reason to keep changing direction and do stuff, then it seems to make more sense. I'm glad to report the dog seems to be taking it in a stride. You know, she's stopping when I want to stop, she's been obedient, she's standing still, although she does seem to paw quite a bit. She's always eager to get on, find the next sniff, whatever it is that's going through her little mind. Anyway, I'll leave you with this nice view of the catkins in spring.